We are beginning tonight with more controversy at the Monterey Peninsula Unified School District.
Tonight, nearly 300 teachers, parents, and students packed a board meeting, many showing up for the district's explanation on its decision to transfer teachers in and out of underperforming schools in Seaside. The district says it's the only way they can strengthen the entire district and qualify for millions of dollars in grant money. Action News reporter Stephanie Truong is live tonight with more on what happened.
Dan, tonight there was also a lot of reaction on the protest from last week on the district's decision. A lot of Seaside High School students and teachers saying they were unfairly put down by others in the district.
But everyone seemed to be doing it.
Monterey High School senior Erin Phillips watched as hundreds of her peers marched out of class Thursday in protest of the district's decision to transfer some of their teachers to Seaside High School. Some of them complaining
that teachers from Seaside are crappy and that they don't want to give our best teachers for their worst teachers when that's not the case at all. And it hurts.
It hurts because her mom, the department chair of mathematics, has been at Seaside High School for 25 years.
When you hear the kids saying that they're going to take the best teachers from Monterey and replace them with the worst teachers from Seaside, that's upsetting to think that that's the perception.
I don't think it's fair to completely judge the whole entire school on, you know, just academics. We're a really diverse school and, you know, we're really well-rounded in a lot of other ways.
The district says the state forced its decision to shuffle 42 teachers out of Seaside schools and bring in replacements from other schools, including Monterey High.
We do need to move 50% of the teachers out of these four schools. So, of course, that's going to impact a little bit.
The move takes Seaside High School, Fitch Middle School, Highland, and King Elementaries out of program improvement, qualifies the district for up to $48 million over the next 3 years. District Associate Superintendent Kari Yater says the decision on which teachers to move in and out was based on credentials and on years of experience.
This is not about getting rid of underperforming teachers. This is about restructuring a school and making sure that we have a balance in our staff at every school.
Still, there has been a mixed reaction on the involuntary transfers.
It was still very upsetting to watch your colleagues go and you're replacing people who really, really want to be at a school with people that perhaps don't necessarily want to be there quite so much.
Whatever happens, happens, and we have to make the best of it.
Now, the district did meet with teachers at the schools for evaluations and says that almost every teacher insisted on staying at his or her school site, but that the tough decisions had to be made. But the teachers can list up to three of their top choices for school and class, and the district says it'll do its best to match those requests up until 3 weeks before the next school year, and then they're just going to have to fill those empty slots. Dan?
All right. Thank you, Stephanie. MPUSD has four other underperforming schools, Ord Terrace, Delray Woods, Marina Vista, and Los Arboles. Those schools have taken different actions, including hiring new principals in the past couple of years. They're still in the program improvement and qualifying for much less funding.